It's a very sought-after pose. It is a deep hip opener, and it's really a lot of work in the sacral chakra area, but it's still an opener for the chest and also for the back. It's a series of four poses, actually, and this week we're going to look at setting it up, and Mariah is going to help me. And then next week we're going to look at some of the variations. So Mariah's going to come to the mat, and we're going to start with the first variation of King Pigeon. It's most easily accessible from down dog, so I'm going to ask Mariah to move into downward facing dog. On an inhale, she's going to lift the right toes up towards the ceiling, opening up the hip flexors. And then on an exhale, she's going to draw those toes through to the front of the mat. The knee is going to be behind the right hand, and the toes are going to be behind the left hand. And to prevent injury in this pose, we want to make sure that we really set it up properly. It's important for the front foot of the bent leg to be flexed and the toes pointing towards the front of the mat. And then we start setting up the shin. In the full variation of Pigeon, the shin is parallel to the mat, but in most of us, that's not accessible. So we just make sure that the foot is flexed and that there's no pressure on the knee. We then check the back leg and make sure that it is shooting straight back so that the hip flexor gets a full opening and stays in a really nice line of energy. And the top of the foot will stay connected to the mat. Sometimes there will be enough space for the right hip to have a block underneath it. In this case, there isn't. But if there is enough space, then you want to put that block underneath to make sure that when you're in the pose, your hips remain stable and level. Mariah is now going to lift her sternum. Chest comes up without putting any pressure on the back of the neck. So we're going to lift the ribs from the back and then lift the ribs from the sternum. And then just gently bring the gaze forward. Coming up onto the fingertips, fingertips on the mat, shine the heart forward, inhale, and on the exhale, release the forehead towards the mat. There may be some discomfort, and listen to the wisdom of your body. If the forehead doesn't want to come to the mat, it can always come to closed fists, which can stack. You can stay on your elbows, and you've also got the possibility of placing the forehead on the block, and you can actually maybe then roll back and forth with the forehead on the block, and this stimulates the vagus nerve. In this case, you want to make sure that the hips are stable, and you've got a really long line of energy in the Pigeon. And Mariah's line is nice and long. So she's opening up the chest and she's breathing deeply into the area of muscle that's working in the hip flexor, which is in flexion, which is an extension. It's in flexion on the right leg and in extension on the left leg. After five deep breaths, she's going to inhale and walk the fingers back in. Shining the heart forward, she's going to lift the back foot if this is comfortable. If it isn't comfortable, she can either leave the foot on the ground or she can always place a blanket under her knee. She's going to reach back with her hand and take the outside of the foot if this is accessible. And she's going to shine the heart forward, feeling an opening in the back and lift the sternum. She's going to find five breaths here, and at the end of those five breaths, she's going to gently release the toes back down, plant the hands, and lift the body into down dog. Really extending and opening. And then when she's finished with down dog, she's going to move into Pigeon on the other side. And so next week, we're going to look at some of the variations for Kapotasana.